working late, jacking cars from
some say the world will end in fire. Some say in ice. From what I've tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. But if I had to perish twice...
I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction, ice is also great. And would suffice. You know, I've got an English final.
Mm. I gotta focus.
Marry me.
Change me.
Okay, I will if you marry me. It's called a compromise.
It's just called coercion. It's not fair. Marriage is just... it's a piece of paper.
Where I'm from... it's the way one says, I love you.
Well, where I come from, at my age, it's the way one says, I just got knocked up.
So, you're worried about what people will think?
You know, 2 out of 3 marriages end in divorce.
Well, I think you'll find the, vampire human divorce rate is a little lower. Just marry me.
I can't. I have to be back at 4.
4 o'clock on the dot. That kid trying to brown nose me now or something?
He has a name. Now he's too punctual for you.
Okay. You understand why you're being punished, right?
I know I put you through hell.
Yes, you did. But I have other reasons for grounding you. Like, I just want you to get some separation from him.
Dad, there's nothing you can say. Edward is in my life.
Yeah, I'm gathering that. So, all right, how about this? I'll make you a deal. You're not grounded anymore if you use your newfound freedom to see some of your other friends, too, like Jacob. He's going through a really tough time right now. His dad's really worried about him. I remember when that was you. You needed a friend. Jake was there.
Hey, it's Jake. Leave a message.
Jacob hadn't talked to me in weeks. I wanted to fix it. He wouldn't give me the chance. Scared me.
You going down that reservation?
How did you meet Alice? Hey, did you do this to my truck?
Bella, you have to understand. Your safety is everything to me.
Jacob's not gonna hurt me.
Not intentionally, but the wolves have no control.
Edward? I have. Until graduation to see him. And then I'll be one of you. And he'll hate me forever.
I'm sorry.
Keep your own away. Good.
Hey.
Just in time. All right, check it out.
All right, let's see what we got.
My fellow students, right?
Wow. Good.
Right? We are the future. Anything is possible if you just believe.
Nice.
Perfect.
You got yourself a speech.
No, this will be my speech when I want everyone to throw diplomas at my head. So, thank you.
You gotta embrace the cliches, Jess.
They are the bread and butter of all valedictorians.
And that is why you are not valedictorian.
It just doesn't need cliches. Speech is gonna be epic.
Epic? It'll change lives. I've decided to throw a party.
After all, how many times are we going to graduate high school?
A party at your place? I've never seen your house.
No one's ever seen their house.
Another party, Alice.
It'll be fun.
Yeah, that's what you said last time. Hey, Angela.
Yeah,
do you need some help with those?
Money.
I know you know what she saw. Tell me.
There was nothing.
You looked worried.
Does everyone notice how strange Alice is?
I think that ship sailed long ago.
We thought this might be...
I wonder what's wrong.
Their son went missing in Seattle over a year ago. Charlie's done what he can.
You know something about this?
We've been tracking the situation in Seattle for a while. Unexplained disappearances, killings. If the situation gets any more conspicuous, the Volturi will step in.
If they go to Seattle, they could come here. They could see I'm still human.
We won't get that far, but we'll go to Seattle if we have to.
I'll fax these down first thing.
Thank you.
Hey.
Hey.
You ready for dinner?
Yeah. It is still just you and I, right?
No, I'm just dropping her off. See you later.
Hey.
Oh, Bella? My parents wanted to remind you about the airline ticket you got for your birthday.
What airline ticket?
A round trip ticket to see Mom in Florida.
Well, that was generous.
It expires soon, so you might want to use it this weekend.
Well, I can't just drop everything and go.
It might be your last chance to see her before you graduate.
Well, might not be a bad idea. Get out of town for a couple of days, get some distance.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind seeing Mom. As long as you use the companion ticket.
Wait, there's two tickets? Super. That makes me really happy.
I did want to see my mom. I wanted to know that her life was full and satisfying.
Aren't you gonna miss this? Can't you just feel the vitamin D soaking up in your pores?
Yeah, I am gonna miss this.
You know, colleges in Florida are a lot sunnier. I'm just saying, if you go to the University of Alaska, I'm never gonna see you.
They have a really great science program.
You mean Edward program? The way he watches you. It's like he's willing to leap in front of you and take a bullet or something.
Not a bad thing.
It's an intense thing. You're different with him. He moves, you move. Like magnets.
I don't know, we're just...
in love. I get it. Just want to make sure you're making the right choices for you. You know, because you're the one that's going to have to live with him. Enough with the heavy.
Mom.
Congratulations.
I didn't want you to spend any of your money.
Ah, it didn't. Come on.
All our old strip t-shirts?
Mm-hmm. Get out. I saved them all. I thought they'd make a good quilt. Keep you warm. Up in Alaska. Remember this one? Enseñada?
The snake pit.
Yep. But this one is my favorite here.
The three-headed lobster from Maine. This is amazing.
Oh, honey, I'm glad you like it. I just figured, you know, when you get older, have kids, we can add to it. Maybe go visit the world's largest ketchup bottle or something.
Thanks.
Oh. I'm glad you like it. She thought you should have a little piece of me up there in Alaska.
Mom.
Yeah.
I miss you.
Oh, honey. I miss you too.
sure this is where you saw her?
She's almost here.
In their territory.
She'll get away!
No, she won't!
Do you regret going?
No. It was really great seeing Mama. It's really hard saying goodbye.
It doesn't have to be goodbye.
Is that why you asked me to go? You thought I was going to change my mind?
I'm always hoping for that.
What?
If I asked you to stay in the car, would you? Of course not.
Hey.
Charlie said you left town?
Yeah, to visit my mom. Why?
Just checking to see if you're still human. Look, I'm here to warn you. If your kind come on our land again.
Wait, what?
You didn't tell her?
Just leave it alone, Jacob.
Tell me what?
Emmett and Paul had a misunderstanding. There's nothing to worry about.
Listen to you. Did you lie to get her out of town, too?
Just leave. Now. She has a right to know. She is the one the redhead wants.
Victoria? Alice's vision.
I was trying to protect you.
By lying to me. Okay, we're gonna talk about this, but... You. Why haven't you called me back?
I had nothing to say.
Well, I have tons. Hold on.
Hey. Oh.
Edward, you have to trust me.
I do trust you. It's him I don't trust.
Hey, who's the Gren, Jacob? We're just going for a ride.
Hold on tight.
Sure, this is a good idea.
I am the vampire girl, remember?
Hey, look, who's back?
What up, Bella?
Quill, you too?
Yep, finally made the pack. I'm glad you're here, Bella. Maybe we can get a break from Jake's obsessive inner monologue.
Which Bella would call.
Which Bella wouldn't call.
Maybe I should call Bella.
Maybe I should call Bella and hang up.
All right, I can shut up now. Bella, this is Leah Clearwater, Harry's daughter.
Hey, I'm really sorry about your father.
If you're here to torture Jacob some more, feel free to leave.
Fun, isn't she?
Bella. Hi.
Hey.
I was wondering when we'd see your face around here again.
Yeah, same here.
Sam, we good?
We're good. She won't be getting through our line anytime soon.
Cool. Yes, hi, boys.
So when did Leah join the pack?
Around when her dad died. Her brother Seth also faced. He's only 15. One of the youngest we've had. Sam keeps him home studying, but he's chomping at the bit. Wish it was Leah who'd stay home.
Come on, don't be such a guy.
No, it's not a chick thing. It's, you know, a triangle thing. We all have to live the Leah, Sam, Emily pain fest. Wolf telepathy, remember?
So Sam dumped Leah for Emily?
Yeah, it wasn't like that. Sam hates himself for hurting Leah. But Emily was the one.
Yeah, I guess it sort of chooses you sometimes.
It's more than some crush, Bella. Sam imprinted on Emily.
Do I even want to know what that is?
Imprinting on someone is like... like when you see her. Everything changes. All of a sudden, it's not gravity holding you to the planet. It's her. Nothing else matters. You would do anything. Be anything for her.
Sounds like you know the feeling. Have you imprinted on someone?
You'd know if I had. Just have a direct line to Sam's thoughts.
So for now, you're still you.
And you're still you.
Yeah. Until graduation.
Graduation.
You knew this was gonna happen.
Not in a month. I mean, not before you've even lived. Or before I could... for a second. Just a second, I thought. But he's got his hooks in you so deep.
I decided this, not him.
Bella, they're not even alive. It makes me sick. Better you really be dead than one of them.
I can't believe you said that. Edward was right, I shouldn't have come.
You know, Edward could at least respect mealtimes.
I was just with Jake.
Oh. Good. I'll just give you two some privacy then.
Hey. Did you understand how worried I'd be?
I was perfectly safe.
I almost broke the treaty to make sure that...
I know, I smell like a dog. I'm sorry.
Something's wrong.
Edward, what's wrong?
Someone's been in here.
Who was it? Someone we know.
This stranger. I didn't recognize his scent.
A nomad passing through.
A passerby wouldn't have left Bella's father alive.
The scent disappeared about 5 miles south of Bella's house.
Someone's orchestrating this.
Victoria? I would have seen her decide.
It has to be the Volturi.
I don't think it's the Volturi either. I've been watching Eris' decisions too.
So we keep looking.
We'll also take shifts guarding Bella at her house.
Another protection detail?
Rosalie.
No, she's right. You can't protect me, watch my dad, and search for the intruder. And for Victoria. And keep yourselves fed.
I'm not leaving you here defenseless.
Well, I'm not gonna let you starve. And I wouldn't be unprotected. I have...
What?
Whoever it was, he left a stink behind. It'll be hard to miss when we cross it again. We'll handle it from here.
We don't need you to handle anything. Or anyone.
I could care less what you need.
All right. We're done here.
No, you're done here.
Stop! I'm tired of this. From now on, I'm Switzerland, okay? Edward hated the idea, but it wasn't about rivalry anymore. It was about my safety and Charlie's. In the days that followed, I got them to at least try to work together. The wolves took over so the Cullens could hunt. It wasn't exactly an easy alliance.
Doesn't he own a shirt?
I'm good here. You should go.
I'm not gonna be gone long.
Don't rush. You need to hunt. Maybe rush a little bit.
Hey, beautiful.
Hi.
So, what you want to do today? Bike, hike, hang, your call. Well, we're going to a party tonight.
You sure this is okay? I really hate being a party crasher.
Technically, you're a council meeting crasher. See? The council leaders, Dad, Quill's grandpa, and Sue Clearwater. She took over for Harry when he died.
Okay, I should not be here.
You're okay. I thought it... I mean, they thought it would be good for you to hear the histories.
The histories? The tribe's histories? Aren't they secret?
We all got a role to play. And you're part of this. I mean, it's the first time Seth, Leah, and Quill will hear them too. But you are the first outsider. Ever.
If I had known that, I would have, like... better dressed better.
Jake!
Hey.
It's about time you got here. Paul's been hoovering the grub, but I saved you some burgers.
Good looking out, bro.
Belle, this is Seth Clearwater, Leah's brother. Newest Hi. Member of the pack.
Newest, bestest, brightest.
And slowest.
Come on, your dad's about to start.
The Quileutes have been a small tribe from the beginning. That we've always had magic in our blood. We were great spirit warriors, shapeshifters. They transformed to the powerful wolf. This enabled us to scare off our enemies and protect our tribe. One day, our warriors came across a creature. It looked like a man. It was hard like stone and cold as ice. Our warrior's sharp teeth finally tore it apart. But only fire would completely destroy it. They lived in fear that the cold man was not alone. And they were right. She took her vengeance out on the village. Our elder chief, Taha Aki, was the only spirit warrior left to save the tribe after his son was killed. Taha Aki's third wife could see that he would lose. The third wife was no magical being, no special powers but one. Courage. Wife's sacrifice distracted the cold woman long enough for Taha Aki to destroy her. She saved the tribe. Over time, our enemies have disappeared, but one remains. The cold ones. Our magic awakens when they're near, and we sense it now. We feel the threat in our blood. Something terrible is coming. And we must all be ready. All of us.
Police are baffled by the escalating murders and disappearances. Theories range from a vicious new gang to a wildly active serial killer. Reporting live, Don Shubay, CNN.
We're going to have to do something.
It takes more than one of our kind to cause the damage they're reporting. Quite a few more. And they're undisciplined, conspicuous.
It's newborns.
What, like new vampires?
In the first few months after the change.
That's when we're at our most uncontrollable, vicious, insane with thirst.
Something to look forward to.
No one's trained these newborns, but this isn't random.
Someone's creating an army.
Well, now we're definitely going to Seattle.
An army of vampires?
And they'd be created to fight someone.
We're the only clan even close to Seattle.
Regardless of why they were made, if we don't put a stop to them, the Volturi will. I'm surprised they let it go on this long.
Maybe they're behind it. In Italy, I read Arrow's mind. He wants me and Alice to join him. But he knows we'll never choose him as long as our family is still alive.
An army could solve that for him.
Hey. Did you eat dinner yet?
No. I haven't. This kid, Riley Beers, disappeared over a year ago. And his poor parents have been papering Seattle with these things ever since.
You think they should just give up?
Well, I wouldn't. If it were you. Not ever.
I have to figure out what to tell people. Why I won't be home for Christmases. Why I won't visit. Why they'll never see me again.
After a few decades, everyone you know will be dead. Problem solved.
Why are you so against me becoming like you?
I told you.
Be honest with me. There's more.
I know the consequences of the choice you're making. I've lived through it. And to let you suffer that, you believe I have a soul, and I don't. But to risk yours just for the sake of never having to lose you, that's the most selfish thing I'll ever do.
I thought that you were afraid that I'd be too different. You know, like, I wouldn't be warm. I wouldn't smell the same.
You'll always be my Bella. Bella just less fragile.
Gosh, it's so pretty here. So, Alice has planned a big graduation party. Which you're invited to. Figured that. What?
I just want to do this differently. Smoother. But now I'm out of time.
Do what?
You need to hear the truth, Bella. Understand all your options. And you need to know that I'm in love with you. And I want you to choose me instead of him.
I thought you understood. I don't feel that way for you.
I don't buy it.
What don't you buy? That's how I feel.
You feel something else for me. You just won't admit it. So I'm not giving up. I'm gonna fight for you. Until your heart stops beating.
Well, then you're not gonna have to fight for long.
You're rushing into it because you're afraid you'll change your mind.
No, I'm not. I know what I want.
You wouldn't have to change for me, Bella. Or say goodbye to anybody. I can give you more than him. I mean, he probably can't even kiss you without hurting you. Feel that? Flesh and blood and warmth.
She's not sure what she wants.
Don't do this.
Let me give you a clue.
Wait for her to say the words.
Fine. And she will.
Kiko, just go, okay?
Easy, guys. Easy. Let's take it down a notch. All right? What's going on?
I kissed Bella. And she broke her hand. Punching my face. Total misunderstanding.
It's just a sprain. Should heal fairly quickly.
Trying to walk and chew gum at the same time again, Bella?
I punched a werewolf in the face.
Badass. There'd be one tough little newborn.
Tough enough to take you on.
Don't worry about it.
Got any leads?
No sign of the intruder. But Victoria continues to make appearances.
Go blather to someone else about the joys of becoming a newborn. Okay. Rosalie. I don't understand what I did to make you hate me so much. I don't hate you. I don't particularly like you, but... Bella, I envy you.
What? That's ridiculous.
No, it's not. You have a choice. I didn't. None of us did, but you do, and you're choosing wrong. I don't care how miserable your human life is.
My life is not miserable. It's not perfect. Nobody's life is perfect.
Mine was. Absolutely perfect. There were things I still wanted. Be married with a nice house and a husband to kiss me when he came home. A family of my own. Royce King was the most eligible bachelor in town. I barely knew him. But I was young. I was in love with the idea of love. On the last night of my life, I left a friend's house late. I wasn't far from home.
Hey, Rose! Come over here.
Here, hold this.
Hey, come over here. We've been waiting for you. There she is.
Rose! You're drunk.
Isn't she lovely, John? I told you she was a looker.
It's hard to say with all those clothes on.
What do you say, Rose? Why don't we take off a few layers?
Stop. I'll see you tomorrow, sober.
Hey, where do you think you're going?
Stop.
Come back. Hey, don't do
anything. Stop. They left me in the street thinking I was dead. Believe me, I wanted to be. Carlisle found me. He smelled all the blood. Thought he was helping me.
I'm sorry.
I got my revenge on them. One at a time. Saved Royce for last so he'd know I was coming. Things got better after I found Emmett. But we'll always be this. Frozen. Never moving forward. That's what I miss the most. Possibilities. Sitting on a front porch somewhere. Emmett gray-haired by my side. Surrounded by our grandchildren. Their laughter.
I understand that that's what you want. There's nothing I'm ever gonna want more than Edward.
You're wrong again. After you've been changed, there's one thing you'll want more. One thing you'll kill for. Blood.
What did I say about a low profile?
Something's coming. Something bigger than any of us alone. And if you can't control yourselves, we're all going to die. What's done is done. Just clean up after yourselves.
They've already drawn too much attention.
So as our inaction, others may begin to question the Volturi's effectiveness.
Nothing.
Maybe we should consult with Arrow.
Arrow's decisions are being watched. We must decide.
And decide, sister. It's time.
Yes, it is. Either we let them do what they were created for, or we end them. Decisions, decisions.
When we were five, they asked us what we wanted to be when we grew up. Our answers were things like astronaut, president, or in my case, a princess. When we were 10, they asked again. We answered rock star, cowboy, or in my case, a gold medalist. But now that we've grown up, they want a serious answer. Well, how about this? Who the hell knows? This isn't the time to make hard and fast decisions. This is the time to make mistakes. Take the wrong train and get stuck somewhere. Fall in love. A lot. Major in philosophy because there's no way to make a career out of that. Change your mind and change it again because nothing's permanent. So make as many mistakes as you can. That way someday when they ask what we want to be, we won't have to guess. We'll know. did you think of my speech? Too easy breezy, too self-helpful, you hated it.
No, you pretty much nailed it.
Yeah? It's like I was born to lead, right? I love this song. Let's go.
What are you doing here?
You invited me, remember?
Was my right hook too subtle for you? That was me uninviting you.
Look, Bella, I'm sorry. About, you know, a kiss in your hand. I'd blame it on the whole inner animal thing, but it was really just me being an ass. I'm really sorry. But I brought you something. Graduation present. I made it myself.
Wow. You made this? It's really pretty. Thanks. I'll be right back. Alice, what'd you see?
The decision's been made.
What's going on?
You're not going to Seattle.
No. They're coming here. They'll be here in 4 days.
This could turn into a bloodbath.
Who's behind it?
I didn't see anyone I recognized. Maybe one.
I know his face. He's local. Riley Beers. He didn't start this.
Whoever did is staying out of the action.
They must be playing with the blind spots in your vision.
Either way, the army's coming, and there aren't enough of us to protect the town.
Hold up. What damn army?
Newborns. Our kind.
What are they after?
They were passing around Bella's scent. A red blouse.
They're after Bella? What the hell does this mean?
It means an ugly fight. With lives lost.
All right. We're in.
No. You'd get yourselves killed, no way.
I wasn't asking for permission.
Edward.
It means more protection for you.
Jacob, do you believe Sam would agree to an understanding? As long as we get to kill some vampires. Jasper?
They'll give us the numbers. Newborns won't know they even exist. That'll give us an edge.
We'll need to coordinate.
Carlo, they're gonna get hurt.
We'll all need some training. Fighting newborns requires knowledge that Jasper has. You're welcome to join us.
All right. Name the time and place.
Jake, you don't know what you're getting yourself into.
Bella, this is what we do. You should be happy. Look at us, working together. You are the one who wanted us to get along, remember?
Again!
Graduation present.
They don't trust us enough to be in their human forms.
They came. That's what matters. Will you translate?
Hey, Jake.
Welcome. Jasper has experience with newborns. Teach us how to defeat them.
They want to know how the newborns differ from us.
They're a great deal stronger than us, because their own human blood lingers in their tissues. Our kind is never more physically powerful than in our first several months of this life.
Carlisle's right. That's why they are created. A newborn army doesn't need thousands like a human army. But no human army could stand against them. Now, the two most important things to remember are, first, never let them get their arms around you. They'll crush you instantly. And second, never go for the obvious kill. They'll be expecting that. And you will lose. Emmett!
Don't hold back.
Not in my nature.
Never lose focus. Never turn your back on your enemy. Singing in songs that makes flame summer.
Some of you are gonna get hurt. Some of you could get killed because of me. It's gonna be 100 times worse than this, right?
Done for the day.
Jasper. Are you sure there's nothing I can do to help?
Well, your presence alone, your scent, will distract the newborns. Their hunting instinct will take over and drive them crazy.
Good. I'm glad. Hey, how do you know so much about this?
I didn't have quite the same upbringing as my adopted siblings.
Those bites are like mine.
Battle scars. All the training the Confederate Army gave me is useless against the newborns. Still, I never lost a fight.
Hey, this happened during the Civil War?
I was the youngest major in the Texas Cavalry. All without having seen any real battle.
Until
I met a certain immortal. Maria. Riding back to Galveston after evacuating a column of women and children, when I saw them, I immediately offered them my aid.
Hmm. Lovely. And an officer.
You'd better do it, Maria. I can never stop once I've started.
What's your name, soldier?
Major Jasper Whitlock, ma'am.
I hope you survive. You may be of great use to me.
Maria was creating an army?
They were very common in the South.
Constant brutal battles for territory. Maria won them all. She was smart, careful, and she had me. I was her second in command. My ability to control emotions served her well. I trained her newborns. In this occupation, since she never let them live beyond the first year, it was my job to dispose of them. Everything they felt. I thought what Maria and I had was love. But I was her puppet. She pulled the strings. I didn't know there was another way. Till I found Alice. Now she's seen me coming, of course.
You kept me waiting long enough.
My apologies, ma'am. I don't know what I've become without her.
You never have to be that again.
Intruder. The newborn army. They're all her puppets. Victoria.
Alice would have seen if she wanted to make an army.
Unless she's hiding behind them. And she's letting someone else decide. Gonna hide while you're out taking all the risks for me.
If it's Victoria involved, I need to keep you as far away from the fight as possible.
Jasper said that I could be of help.
We won't need your help. With the wolves in this, it's an easy win. The rest of us aren't gonna have enough to do.
Okay, either it's so dangerous that I have to hide, or it's so easy that you're gonna be sidelined. Which is it?
It's dangerous for you. It's easy for us.
I think it's dangerous for us to be apart. How many times do we have to prove that? I'll be worried. You'll be worried. and we'll both be more vulnerable.
Okay, you're right.
So I'm coming with you.
No, we both stay away together.
I can't make you choose between me and your family.
The only way I can protect you is to be with you.
You're not fighting? What, did you pull a muscle or something?
He's doing it for me, okay?
Whatever. Just tell me the plan.
This field will give us an advantage in battle. We need to lure the newborns with Bella's scent. It needs to end here.
Edward and I are going to a campsite. Even if he carries me, they'll still pick up on our scent.
Your stench, however, is revolting.
Dude, you really don't want to start comparing stinks.
What he means is that your scent will mask mine if you carry me.
Done.
This is not a good idea.
Edward, they won't want to get anywhere near his odor.
Okay, let's just try it.
Oda Wolf coming up.
Run.
So you can ask me to sit out of the fight too? Or don't you care about my safety?
Of course I care. But you'd say no.
So I won't have a choice anyways. Since I let Sam be alpha male, I gotta live with the shots he calls.
Since you let Sam be alpha?
I didn't want to be in a pack, let alone be its leader.
Wow. Chief Jacob.
Opted out. But every choice has its consequences. Some more than others.
Don't start. Everybody makes choices. You're gonna have to accept mine.
But you can love more than one person at a time. I've seen it. With Sam, Emily, and Leah.
Well, I'm not a wolf. I can't imprint.
It has nothing to do with imprinting. It has to do with feeling something for somebody. And I know you feel something for me. I can sense how I make you feel. Physically. I make you nervous.
Jake.
Don't worry. I promised I wouldn't kiss you again until you asked.
You're gonna be keeping that promise for a while, Chief.
All I picked up was wolf stench. No Bella. This will work.
Great.
Yes.
Okay, Alice, don't be a stranger.
Okay. Your alibi for the battle is all arranged.
Really?
I told your father that our whole family is going camping this weekend, so you and I are having a sleepover at my house. Charlie's going fishing anyway.
Charlie? You guys are on first name basis now?
Me, he likes. Actually, you and Edward will have the house to yourself tonight.
Like alone?
We're all going hunting. Powering up for the battle. You're welcome.
Hey. You want a sandwich?
No, I'm good.
Well, the sister I like.
Alice. Yeah, she's great. Hey, Ted. I was wondering. Why don't you get remarried after Mom?
I don't know. Guess I still haven't met the right gal. Why?
I don't know. I thought you just maybe gave up on the whole institution of it. Of marriage. But do you think there's any value in it?
Yeah. Yeah, marriage has value. When you're older, much older, like your mother,
seemed to work out fine for her the second time around. Later in life.
Yeah, I guess.
I mean, you definitely don't want to have to get married because you weren't careful.
What?
But you know what I'm talking about. There's things that you need to think about if you're going to be physically intimate.
Okay. Don't have the talk.
Well, it's just as embarrassing for me as it is for you.
I doubt that. And don't bother, because Mom beat you to it like 10 years ago.
Well, you didn't have a boyfriend 10 years ago.
I'm sure things work the same way.
All right. So, you guys are taking precautions. And...
Okay, Dad, please just don't worry about that. Edward is old school.
Old school. Great. What's that, like code for something?
Oh, my God. Dad, I'm a virgin.
Ah, the. Okay, good. Glad we covered that.
Me too.
Virgin. Liking Edward a little bit more now.
What are you doing outside? What's wrong?
Nothing.
It seems only fair that I be represented as well.
Bed.
I thought you might need one to sleep in.
I think an air mattress would have sufficed.
Is it too much?
No. No, it's perfect. I want to ask you something.
Anything.
Okay, marriage is the condition for you to change me yourself, right?
Yes.
Okay. I want to negotiate my own condition.
Anything you want. It's yours.
You promise?
Yeah.
Human experience.
Not ones that will risk killing you.
You won't. And everyone says that once I'm changed, all I'm gonna want is to slaughter the whole town.
That part doesn't last forever.
I want you. Well, I'm still me. Well, I still want you this way.
It's too dangerous.
Try. I'll go to some ridiculously expensive college and let you buy me a car. I'll marry you. Just try. me, you don't. It's fine.
Believe me, I want to. I just want to be married to you first.
You really make me feel like I'm some sort of, like, villain trying to steal your virtue or something.
It's not my virtue I'm concerned about.
Are you kidding?
It's just one rule I want to leave unbroken. It might be too late for my soul, but I will protect yours. I know it's not a modern notion.
It's not modern. It's ancient.
I'm from a different era. Things were a lot less complicated. And if I'd met you back then, I would have courted you. Would have taken chaperone strolls and had iced tea on the porch. I may have stolen a kiss or two, but only after asking your father's permission, I would have got down on one knee. And I would have presented you with a ring. This was my mother's. Isabella Swan, I promise to love you every moment forever. Would you do me the extraordinary honor of marrying me?
Yes.
It'll be a last-minute decision. I told you how it works.
The Cullens have powers.
Don't underestimate them, Riley. You'll have the numbers, but they'll be able to anticipate your every move.
According to your friend?
Yes. My dead friend. Laurent found out about the things they could do. And they killed him. But not before he told me.
Maybe he was wrong. I mean, this is supposed to be Cullen territory. We've been tearing it up, and I've never even seen the mayor.
You don't trust me.
With my life. Just saying.
I'm doing this for us, so that we can feed without their retaliation. I can't live in fear anymore, waiting for them to attack.
Look, I won't let them. I am going to end.
So much.
going overboard.
If this is all I can contribute, I want to be thorough.
The newborns will be frantic.
It's okay. Don't make yourself uncomfortable.
It doesn't bother me anymore.
Since when?
Since I spent 24 hours thinking you were dead. You're not wearing your ring.
Well, I didn't want to risk losing it.
I'll risk Jacob seeing it.
I think we should wait to tell him. I mean, at least till after the fight.
If you're having second thoughts.
I'm not. I just want him to have a clear head.
Whose head is unclear?
Nobody's, I hope.
Alice says there's a storm coming.
Yeah, I can feel it. We should get going.
I'll see you in a couple of hours.
Something up?
Bunch of vampires trying to kill me?
Same old, same old.
You should get back before the storm hits.
No, I'm staying. You'll need my connection to the pack to keep tabs on what's going on.
You're not gonna fight?
Seth will spell me in the morning. He's not happy about missing the action, but it'll keep him out of trouble.
Let's get you inside. Side lower down.
No, it's fine. I'm okay.
What can I do?
I can't sleep with all that teeth chattering going on.
Get it.
She may need her toes someday. And let's face it, I am hotter than you. Get your hand off me.
Keep your hands off her.
Don't fight.
If she gets sick, it's on you. Freezing, Bella. Relax. You'll warm up soon. Faster if you took your clothes off.
Jake.
Survival 101.
Thank you.
Can you at least attempt to control your thoughts?
I really get under that ice-cold skin of yours, don't I? What? Are you doubting her feelings for you? Nice. So picking through my brain's okay, but letting me into yours, forget it. Look, I know she's in love with you.
Oh, good.
But she's in love with me, too. She just won't admit it to herself.
I can't tell if you're right.
Then let me ask you something. If she chooses me...
She won't.
If she did... Would you try to kill me?
That's an intriguing idea. But no. I couldn't hurt her like that.
So you'd just turn her into a blood-sucking demon like you?
I don't want that. I never wanted that.
So stop her.
I tried. I left.
But you gave up too quickly. If you'd stayed away another 6 months, I could have made her happy. Trust me. You have to consider that I might be better for her than you are.
I have considered that. I know you can protect her. But you can give her a life, a human life. That's all I want for her. I'm not going to force her into anything ever again. The last time I tried, it almost killed us both.
Yeah, that I remember. When you thought she was gone. That you'd lost her. How did you cope?
There are no words. But I wouldn't wish it on anyone, Jacob. This might sound odd, but I'm glad you're here.
Meaning? As much as I'd love to kill you, I'm glad she's warm.
If we weren't natural enemies, and you weren't trying to steal my reason for existing, I might actually like you.
Well, if you weren't planning on sucking the life out of the girl I love, I might... No. Not even then. But she could still change her mind, you know.
Then I'd let her go.
Where's Jacob? Did he already...
Not yet. He's checking to see if the woods are clear before he goes.
I'm really sorry about last night. I couldn't have been easy on you.
Definitely won't make my list of top 10 favorite evenings.
You have a list?
All 10 I spent with you. Number one is when you said you'd marry me. Mrs. Cullen.
This is the 21st century. I at least want to hyphenate my name.
You're marrying him?
Jake, you knew he was listening.
He deserves to know.
Jake, stop!
Bella, let him...
Don't! Jake, stop! Jake, please!
I'm done. I'm so done.
What can I do?
You can't do anything. I can. By going out there and killing something.
No! You're not thinking clearly. Don't do that!
Well, maybe I'll get myself killed and make it simple for you.
No! Just... Jake, stay.
Why? Give me one good reason.
Because I don't want to lose you.
It's not good enough.
Because you're too important.
It's still not good enough.
Jacob! Kiss me. I'm asking you to kiss me. You saw?
No, but Jacob's thoughts are pretty loud.
I don't know what happened.
You love him.
I love you more.
I know. Jacob just got there. He's good.
Thank you. Someone's hurt?
She's close. I can hear her thoughts. Seth, go. She knew we weren't there, but she caught my scent. She knew you'd be with me.
She found us.
She's not alone. Riley, listen to me. Victoria's just using you to distract me. She knows I'll kill you. In fact, she'll be glad she doesn't have to deal with you anymore.
Don't listen, Riley. I told you about their mind tricks.
I can read her mind, so I know what she thinks of you.
He's lying.
She only created you and this army to avenge her true mate, James. That's the only thing she cares about, not you.
There's only you. You know that.
Think about it. You're from Forks. You know the area. That's the only reason she chose you. She doesn't love you.
Riley, don't let him do this to us. You know I love you.
You're dead.
Pain you felt when I killed James. When I tore him to pieces. When I turned him into ash. When I turned him into nothing.
wrong?
Alice needs us to go. Now.
Maybe 10?
The pack needs to leave. Voltori won't honor a truce with the werewolves.
Leah, don't! Gonna take care of you.
The bones on the right half of his body are shattered.
Bella. Jake, I'm right here. Jacob, you idiot, I had it!
Leah!
I need to set the bones before his accelerated healing kicks in. It's already starting.
No, we need to get him out of here. We're not gonna win a fight with the Volturi.
We'll take him back to Billy's.
I'll be there as soon as I can.
Hang in there, Jake.
We got you.
They're coming. Impressive. I've never seen a coven escape an assault of this magnitude intact.
We were lucky.
I doubt that.
It appears we missed an entertaining fight.
Yes. It's not often we're rendered unnecessary.
If you'd arrived a half hour ago, you would have fulfilled your purpose.
Pity. You missed one.
We offered her asylum in exchange for her surrender.
That wasn't yours to offer. Why did you come? Who created you?
You don't need to do that. She'll tell you anything you want to know.
I know.
Her name was Victoria. Perhaps you knew her.
Edward, if the Volturi had knowledge of Victoria, they would have stopped her. Isn't that right, Jane?
Of course. Felix.
She didn't know what she was doing. We'll take responsibility for her.
Give her a chance.
The Volturi don't give second chances. Keep that in mind. Caius will be interested to know that she's still human.
The date is set.
Take care of that, Felix. I'd like to go home.
Going on for a while.
Docs were breaking his bones.
Why did he have to butt in? I could have taken that tip.
I'll give it a rest, Leah.
The worst is over. He'll be all right. I gave him some morphine, but his body temperature will burn it off soon. I'll come back to set up a drip.
Thank you.
He's asking for you.
I was worried about you.
You were worried about me?
Yeah. I guessed Edward would read my thoughts. Was he hard on you?
He wasn't even mad at me. Or you.
Well, damn. He's better than I thought.
He's not playing the game.
You think?
I know who he is. Let's not talk about that.
I'd rather get all the rebreaking done at once. Well, at least I know I did everything. It wasn't easy making you admit your feelings for me.
I only fought them because I knew they wouldn't change anything.
I'm exactly right for you, Bella. It would be as easy as breathing. You know how much I wish it was enough.
Should I come back?
I need some time. But I'll always be waiting.
August 13th.
Yeah. It's a month before my birthday. I don't need to be another year older than you. Alice said she could get the wedding together by then.
I'm sure she can. There's no rush.
Chosen my wife. I'm gonna start living it.
And so you're gonna let Alice plan the whole thing? The dress, the reception, the guest list. I mean, who knows who she's gonna invite?
Doesn't matter.
Just tell her why you're doing this.
What? The wedding?
No. You're trying to make everyone else happy. But you're already giving away too much.
You're wrong.
This wasn't a choice between you and Jacob. It was between who I should be and who I am. I've always felt out of step. Like literally stumbling through my life. I've never felt normal. Because I'm not normal. I don't want to be. I've had to face death and loss and pain in your world, but I've also never felt stronger. Like more real, more myself. Because it's my world too. It's where I belong.
So it's not just about me.
No. Sorry. I've made a mess trying to figure all this out, but I want to do it right. And I want to tie myself to you in every way humanly possible.
I'm starting with a wedding.
Actually, something a little more difficult first, and maybe even dangerous. We have to tell Charlie.
It's highly dangerous.
It's a good thing you're bulletproof. I'm gonna need that ring.
Always tell was a heavy heart to carry. My beloved was weighed down. My arms around her neck, my fingers laced a crown. I was a heavy heart to carry. My feet dragged across the ground. And he took me to the river, where he slowly let me drown. My love has concrete feet. My love's an iron ball wrapped around your ankles over the waterfall. I'm so heavy, heavy, heavy.
Who's the king?